Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. All right, so you guys know what that means, okay? Once again, we have a story about the Pissy Pied Piper. And so when we last left off with this story, I was telling y'all that I cannot believe my eyes. Just like that damn Sudanese woman.
I cannot believe my eyes. I cannot believe my eyes.
Y'all know I have no damn chill. So anyways, R. Kelly's ass was stuck in jail all weekend. And then what happened is that it came out that R. Kelly is broke, which is a shock to no one. Because when you can't perform and you're getting blacklisted all over the country and you can't read, you can't write, you can't do arithmetic, how do y'all expect him to make money, okay? So of course he couldn't bail himself out. But there's a woman named Valencia Love who decided to show R. Kelly some love. And she decided to bail R. Kelly out. So this was causing a lot of controversy. Let me go ahead and break this down to you guys. So the woman is a Chicago businesswoman, and this is what the Chicago Sun-Times is reporting. They're saying an R. Kelly friend and advisor said that within a few months of meeting the R&B singer, Valencia Love posted $100,000 to help Kelly win his freedom from Cook County Jail after he spent 3 nights in custody. Love was a fan of R. Kelly's music when she met the 52-year-old singer aboard a Spirit of Chicago cruise on Lake Michigan in September, Russell said. Over the weekend, she called members of R. Kelly's inner circle and told them that she wanted to help when she saw that he wasn't able to make bail. She wanted Rob to have a chance at justice and thought that he'd have a better chance outside of jail than inside of jail. So then it was revealed that Valencia is also an owner, okay? She's a Chicago business owner. She runs a daycare and a restaurant. And when I tell you folks were lighting her Yelp up, they went on to Yelp and they were Yelping their asses off, okay? They were dragging this woman. And people were really disgusted because it's like, dude, you run a daycare with little girls. Like, are you serious? Why are you even involving yourself in this fuck shit? And my thing is, if R. Kelly has helped all these people, he has this tight inner circle, why the hell his inner circle couldn't have bailed him out of jail? Why are you using your money to bail R. Kelly out of jail, a man that you barely even know? But on top of that, they said the way that she got the money is that she had lost her daughter a few years ago. So it was some type of settlement. She basically took her daughter's settlement money from her daughter's death and used it to bail out R. Kelly. When I tell you, honey, these fans are out here wildin', you can't tell them shit. Once they're a true fan of somebody, they are so ride or die, it's damn ridiculous, okay? So anyways, so now in some other R. Kelly tea, what's going on is this. After he got out of jail, he was spotted at the same McDonald's that he was always out there, you know, cruising for young street meat, okay? So he went to his same McDonald's, and a lot of people are dragging him, and Michael Aventi is saying that, you know, that was a violation of his terms of agreement. But let's keep it real. R. Kelly has no money. Like, where did y'all expect him to go eat? You know, I'm no fan of his. Was he supposed to go eat at a 5-star restaurant? He's going to go eat somewhere cheap and fast, okay? And, you know, sorry it happened to be McDonald's, because that's the main McDonald's that he used to go to, you know, to pick up young girls. But I'm not shocked at all that he went to McDonald's, because he ain't got no damn money. The only thing he can do is order off the damn dollar menu, okay? Hopefully he didn't turn around and get a kid's Happy Meal, if you know what I'm implying, okay? Anyways, so now the Savages are back on the map. So if you guys do not know, the Savages are meeting with the FBI. They claim that they have physical evidence that R. Kelly basically, you know, is sleeping with these girls and kidnapped their daughter and all that good shit. So this is what TMZ is reporting. They're saying that Jocelyn Savage's parents are set to meet with federal investigators in New York to discuss matters related to two separate U.S. Attorney Office probes into Kelly, one by the Eastern District of New York, another by the Southern District. We're told that the Savages will provide information on witnesses and those closely associated with Kelly and turn over materials they refer to as physical evidence. Federal investigators are progressing very quickly thanks to the cooperation and testimony from several people, including Michael Aventi and some of his clients. As for what the feds could pin on Kelly, it could involve the Mann Act, which prohibits the transportation of minors across state lines for the purpose of sex or debauchery. So they are really coming after R. Kelly. You guys know how I feel about these so-called grown R. Kelly accusers and a lot of these parents. I can't take the savages seriously, because before you allowed your daughter, before you pimped your daughter, Jocelyn, to go off with R. Kelly, you knew his background. You, like many of us, were aware of the Aaliyah situation, but you didn't care because you felt like this was a come up for y'all. This was a way for your daughter to become famous, for y'all to get rich, to eat off your daughter. And you literally sold your daughter off to R. Kelly. So I'm going to always give these parents the side eye. And the fact that Jocelyn is still there and has not ran off and she's going to court with him, it says a lot. And yeah, she could be brainwashed, it could be Stockholm syndrome, but the common denominator is, as a parent, it was your job to protect her, and you guys were basically well involved with the whole R. Kelly situation, you know. And then eventually, once your daughter turned 19, she was like, you know what, I'm out this bitch, I'm moving in with R. Kelly. So, you know, like I said, between the savages and the Currys, I still give them the side eye, but that does not negate the fucked up shit that R. Kelly is doing, okay? Now, in other updated R. Kelly news, if you guys do not know, the girl Lisa Van Allen, she's the one who was in the sex tape having sex with the 14-year-old girl, claiming that she didn't know she was 14. But anyways, she's not talking to TMZ as well. And she told TMZ that she is one of the two young women in the original R. Kelly sex tape for which he went to trial, but was ultimately acquitted. She was 17 at the time that the tape was recorded. Lisa tells TMZ everything R. Kelly allegedly does in the video, such as coaching the teen through sex, choking her, calling out her age. Sounds like the same Kelly she was dating. She also believes Avenatti is on point with his allegations about Kelly's camp intimidating witnesses in the 2008 trial. She's written a book called Surviving the Pied Piper about her time with R. Kelly. Interesting that she's using that damn name, knowing that we've been calling him the Pissy Pied Piper for a while here on my damn channel. Anyways, you know, I just find this interesting with her as well. She also spoke on video to TMZ. Y'all go ahead and check this out.
You know, I think he was acquitted, not because he was innocent, because they clearly said that was him on the tape. But they also said that they were unable to prove beyond reasonable doubt that that was a 14-year-old, being that the girl did say under oath that it wasn't her, even though, you know, I testified that it was her, and it was, because, you know, I've had a sexual act with them as well, so.
Michael Avenatti submitted a second video to the state's attorney in Chicago, and it described in lurid detail what is on that video. Did you read about the description, and does that ring true to you?
Yeah, honestly, what he stated thus far, what I know, it's very familiar to me what he's talking about. You know, I feel like they have a very strong case.
All right, so you guys just saw her video. So like I said, it's very interesting, you know, that she has a book out. A lot of these girls are now promoting themselves and, you know, trying to make money off this scandal, you know. It's America. We live in a capitalistic society, so I'm not shocked. But I just do find it disturbing that she's the one who leaked the sex tape out. She gave it to two guys. And allegedly, from what I was told, they were using it to blackmail R. Kelly. And once R. Kelly, you know, couldn't pay anymore, refused to pay, that's when the tape was sent to the Chicago Sun-Times. So my thing is this, I have to give her the side eye as well, because by the time she was giving that tape to those two guys, she was well over the age of 18. And if you're really concerned about that minor in the tape, and you were really concerned about, you know, getting the truth out there, once you got your hands on that tape, you would have taken the tape to the police right there and then, let them know that you were a victim at the time at 17, and, you know, this man should be in jail for what he did. You would have went straight to the police with that tape, but instead, you kept that tape, you and your two guy friends kept that tape for a few years and used it to blackmail R. Kelly, and then once you guys couldn't get what you wanted out of him, then at that point, it's, oh, you know, I want to go ahead and help this young girl that's being victimized in the tape that I also helped to victimize with R. Kelly. So like I said, a lot of these so-called victims, I'm still giving them the side eye. The Surviving R. Kelly documentary to me opened up my eyes in different ways. You know, okay, we watch. I understood where some of them were coming from. But several of them still get the side eye from me. So this entire situation is crazy. I think they're going to throw the book at R. Kelly. I think R. Kelly's going to end up finally doing some time. You know, if he doesn't run off to Bali with damn, you know, Russell Simmons, we all know that he's on a self-proposed exile out there. And maybe R. Kelly might go out there too. Who knows? But this entire situation is just insane. But I'm not shocked at all of what is going on with the Pissy Pied Piper. Let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire crazy situation. Once again, concerning the Pissy Pied Piper, him getting bonded out by Valencia, who owns a daycare, and then the Savages and Lisa Van Allen meeting with prosecutors and the feds to bring up even more charges on R. Kelly. And then last but not least, how do you guys feel about this man who is worth millions of dollars is now broke? And I really feel like that is the main reason why all these people are coming out, from these girls to Drea Kelly, is because the gravy train has ended. Everybody sat back idly for years, helped him get numbers, helped him recruit other girls. I've spoken about this in several videos. Go back and watch my videos. Go back and watch my breakdowns. A lot of these people are just as guilty for looking the other way in this R. Kelly situation. And I feel like if R. Kelly goes down, a lot of these folks need to go down with him, okay? He wasn't doing this by himself. Who was booking these plane flights? Who were getting these girls, you know, to go from one side of the country to R. Kelly's mansion? Who was driving these young girls to R. Kelly? Who was out at the mall with R. Kelly recruiting these young girls? You know, so there's a lot of people involved in this fuck shit. The rabbit hole goes deep, but I'm going to be here to stay on top of it. So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment.